Twitter is taking the world by storm. But when you enter the world of publishing online, you enter the world of libel. In the old days, the people most concerned with libel laws would have been newspaper editors, and of course the politicians and celebrities they would be writing about. But all that's changed. You see, nowadays, you can publish your opinions on the internet for millions of people to read. It's a new world we're living in. But the trouble is, you don't play by the old world rules. You can publish and be damned. This small town in South Wales is the battleground in the UK's first case of twibel. Twibel is when a libel, a false and defamatory statement, is published on Twitter. And thanks to just one tweet, a councillor here in Caerphilly is facing a legal bill for tens of thousands of pounds. Now, it might sound like a storm in a teacup. One councillor having a dig at a rival. Part of the cut and thrust of local politics, really. Or so you might think. Because as soon as you put your thoughts onto the World Wide Web, all of a sudden, small-town politics become a lot more serious. Eddie Talbot runs a model and hobby shop in Caerphilly. Already a town councillor, he was fighting former Mayor Colin Elsbury for a seat on the County Borough Council. On the day of the vote, Councillor Elsbury tweeted that Councillor Talbot had to be removed by the police from a polling station. But that was completely untrue and defamatory, and Mr Talbot sued for libel.
When I went down the pub in the evening, there was people in the pub sort of having a good laugh and a joke over it, and at my expense. I had a lot of support from a local church and the Women's Institute. They were coming and asking me what was going on. There was certainly a lot of questions being asked at the time as to what had actually gone on. Again, no smoke without fire.
When the case was finally settled in court, Colin Elsbury was ordered to pay damages and apologise to Eddie Talbot. Now, it's the first time in the UK that damages have been awarded for libel on Twitter. These damages were set at £3,000, but it doesn't end there, because Councillor Elsbury will have to pay legal costs running into tens of thousands of pounds.
The Twitter libel that we've recently seen in Wales really is a rather bad precedent, in my view, because it opens the floodgates for many hundreds of thousands of cases to come to court. That one would get a libel writ, that one would get a libel writ, that one wouldn't, that one would. I think it would be sensible to have places like Twitter, Facebook and other social networking sites protected from the libel laws. I think we don't really want to have people found responsible for them unless they are malicious or they cause some financial loss in some way. I think the libel laws are clearly not fit for the internet age. They're Victorian laws and they're being dragged kicking and screaming into the 21st century.
Back in Caerphilly, Colin Elsbury is counting the cost financially and personally. The Ministry of Justice has published a draft defamation bill and says it wants to limit costs and make the law fit for the modern age. Even the man who was twibled regrets it came to this.
Basically a sledgehammer to crack a walnut. It should never have got that far. If it had been me and it was a total role reversal, it would have been a strong handshake and an apology in a council chamber or wherever, and that would have been the end of the matter.
Do you have any sympathy for Colin Elsbury?
Immense sympathy for him. The implication of the costs on his family and family life for years to come. It's huge, absolutely huge. And I wouldn't wish that on anybody, but it was his own doing.
Colin Elsbury did not want to make any comment to The One Show. As agreed in court, he has now made a full written apology to Eddie Talbot. It's prominently displayed on his Twitter page, of course.
Oh, that. Quite useful.